Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Hey, if you hear this message, firstly, drop a follow. Secondly, if you're on YouTube, subscribe. If you don't care about anything, don't do anything. And if you're really helpful, maybe so. I don't know. You do you, gang. Listen to music now, please. This one.
So I've got my
not that one. This one. What's up, guys, eh? How are we doing? Hello, James. Hello, Mia. Guys, hey, I got a bit of a fun stream for you today where we're gonna have a look at, obviously, classic. I've got a few things I want to talk about, a few things I want to ask. Oh, I've got my phone. Okay, thank God. Else this stream would have been off the rails before it even started. I need to plug it into charge, actually, else we're not gonna have a stream at all. Boys, okay, we have discussion time because, as probably you've been told by every news outlet ever, Will Smith slapped someone. We're going to look at the facts. Then we're going to have opinions. Because I have some opinions I want to share. I don't want to bias anything. So I'm not going to say anything what I think of it until we've done the facts. Because the facts are quite interesting to look at, right? I'm going to break down. If you didn't understand the joke, which I didn't, I'm going to explain the joke. We're also going to look at the condition that Jada... Is her name Jada? Yeah. Jada has. We're going to do this properly, and I'm rather excited. So... Guys. Now, I have some other news to talk about. But yeah, that's the plan for today, guys. What else do I have in my notes? Okay. Are we ready, eh? I also brought with me snack of choice today, chat, is some hot cross bun fudge. And it's good. But it does taste a little bit odd. Okay. I say, you know what, guys, let's jump into it. Firstly, let's look at the facts. And the easiest way to do this is to actually watch what happened. So, allow me to pull up the clip. Let me get a clip.
Want a better...
No, I don't. Broadband deal? No, I don't, actually. I don't... I'm not that happy. Okay. Here we go. Let's watch what unfolded at... at the Oscars last night. So yeah, it was at the Oscars. It was a comedian called Chris Rock on stage. Here we go.
You know who's got the hardest job tonight? Javier Bardem and his wife are both nominated. Now, if she loses, he can't win. He is praying that Will Smith wins. Like, please.
Let me have a look at... hang on. Why is there a yellow bar at the bottom, guys? Let me sort that out. There we go.
Lord!
There's Jada, Will Smith.
I love you. G.I. Jane 2. Can't wait to see it. All right?
There's the joke. G.I. Jane 2. Now, the joke is simple. G.I. Jane is... Can we see Jada in this image? There's Jada. Right. The big thing to remember is Jada is bald. Right? Now if we look at G.I. Jane, you can tell everyone's been searching for it. G.I. Jane is a film, about a bald woman who, gets in the military. I think she kicks everyone's ass and it's like against all odds. She gets in the military and she's become a Senate Armed Service Committee interviews a candidate for the position of Secretary of Naval. Senator from Texas cites the Navy for not to be being gender neutral behind the curtains. A deal is struck. If women compare favorably to the men, series of tests, the military will integrate women fully into... So basically, it's woman gets in Navy, woman bald. That's the joke. It's that she's bald, right? Now, why this sets off alarms, right, is because Jada has alopecia. Now, we'll get on to what alopecia is in a minute. But... basically, Will's obviously, at this point, Will is loving it, right? Good joke. You can see he's a grinning man. She thought it was kind of funny. Jada, didn't really like that one. Not happy at all. Do you see that roll of the eyes? He knows.
That was a nice one. Okay. I'm out here. Uh-oh. Richard.
Here comes Will Smith.
Oh, wow.
He's happy with himself.
Will Smith just smacked the shit out of me.
Good observational comedy there.
Get my name out your fucking mouth.
Wow, dude.
Yes.
It was a G.I. Jane jump.
Keep my wife's name out your fucking mouth.
I'm going to, okay? Okay. That was a Greatest night in the history of television. Okay. Okay.
I really knocked him. To be fair, he conducted himself pretty well. I live for this woman in the gold dress at the back. I feel she's just repping it. She is us. She's us right now. Right. So, obviously, I think what happened here is... because obviously we see Will laughing, right? I think Will laughs. Wife looks at him and goes... And then Will goes, I fucked up it. I need to make up for it, right? Kind of realizes what he's done. And then obviously the events unfold, right? And then we move on to, we get Will Smith's speech afterwards. Let me get this up. Watch later. Here we go. I got everything saved. I was prepared for this stream. I really thought it out. We've got an advert, guys. Don't worry about that. Don't worry about that. It's fine. Oh, wait. This is the 59 seconds.
We do.
Hang on. I want the full version. Here we go.
You got to be able to take abuse. You got to be able to have people talk crazy about you. In this business, you got to be able to have people disrespecting you. And you got to smile and you got to pretend like that's okay. I want to apologize to the Academy. I want to apologize to all my fellow nominees.
The room is deathly silent.
This is a beautiful moment, and I'm not crying for winning an award. It's not about winning an award for me. It's about being able to shine light on all of the people, Tim and Trevor and Zach and Sanaya and Demi and Ingenue and the entire cast and crew of King Richard and Venus and Serena, the entire Williams family.
She's loving it.
Art imitates life. I look like the crazy father, just like they said. I look like crazy father, just like they said about Richard Williams. But love will make you do crazy things. Being able to love and care for my mother and my family, my wife. I'm taking up too much time. Thank you for this honor. Thank you for this moment. And thank you on behalf of Richard and Orsine, the entire Williams family. Thank you, Hoping Academy.
Guys, not now. Okay. So, let's break it down here. We've had Will Smith. Chris Rock makes joke. Will Smith slaps Chris Rock. Will Smith wins award. Makes speech about love and peace, right? Now, I think an important thing to consider, and this is what... Okay, we're going to start moving into opinion now. I've tried to try and stay neutral, but I'm going to move into opinion now because I feel this is where the more interesting stuff is. What I think is important to consider is Jada has alopecia, right? Now, for those of you who were like me, didn't know what alopecia was, alopecia is... I kind of think he might run for president. Yeah, that would be interesting. Alopecia is literally balding. Right. Now, I understand that obviously balding for a woman and a man is completely like, there's a lot more that goes into, there's a lot more stress surrounding women and balding. But alopecia... is there? It's not like cancer. It's not like leukemia. I think that's also cancer. I'm not really sure. I'm not very good at diseases and stuff. Where it's a side effect. That's the whole disease. You're just balding. Which Now, I get it can be stressful. But at the same time, looking at the facts here, right? We have Will Smith, who is going on stage and slapping a man. You're balding. Well, I hope not. I hope I'm not. Well, so if we look at the facts, right? Jada is obviously balding, which can be scary. If my hair started falling out, I would panic. I think that's fair. But at the end of the day, G.I. Jade, right, is obviously who they have been compared to. And it's not a bad comparison, really. And I think, okay, you gotta know your audience, and if she's really ramming at home about how much she, like, how distressed she is about having alopecia, which she clearly is. There's lots of clips of her talking about how much she doesn't like alopecia. Know your audience. Don't go in with a joke about it, you know? But at the same time, it's a lol, you're balding joke. And to then go on stage and slap someone and then give a speech about love and peace, I gotta side with Thingy Rock here. I gotta side with Chris Rock. That's it. And I don't want to sway people's opinions, because that's not what I'm here to do. But the way I look at it is, A, Will speaks facts in his speech. There's no doubt about that. He says, hey, you gotta be able to take criticism. You gotta be able to spread love, spread peace, right? And neither of those things were displayed when he went and slapped Chris Rock, right? Banging stream right now. Thanks, James. So, looking at the situation. Now, I want to get on something about jokes, right? Because this was something I was talking to someone about the other day. I don't know if they want to be named, so I'm not going to name them. Generally, when I do Hot Topic things, we don't name people. Because the only person I'm trying to take down here is myself. But jokes are, like, there is a line, right? I think everybody has a different line, though. You know, some people prefer to push it a bit further, while some don't want to push it too far. Oh, I need to sort my chat out. And for some people, some stuff is off limits, and some people stuff isn't. And so, you know, it's a world where lots of people have lots of opinions, right? But I don't want to be the person who is pushing the limit. I don't know. That doesn't really suit me. I don't want to be doing that. I don't want to be pushing the limits of comedy. I'm not here to do that. But I do rate it when people do, right? Because it means that it gives us wiggle room for the rest of us. People have got to go over the line to know where it is. And arguably, I wouldn't say that Chris Rock... Please align it with your follower foul. Now, I would not say Chris Rock has particularly pushed over the line here. I don't think what he said is completely unacceptable. Yeah, maybe. I don't think it was the best joke in the world, because A, like, everybody had to go and Google who G.I. Jane was, and B, obviously, it was not, like, it didn't go down well. But I can understand why he did it, and I can understand why it was funny. Like, I think it's a bit of a cheap joke, but it is funny. And so on this side, I 100% back Chris Rock. But I do understand why they'd be annoyed. But that's definitely no excuse for going up and hitting someone. I think the other thing too important to consider is, yes, alopecia, it is distressing. It is. It's not nice to have, but at the same time, man, you're balding. Millions of people are balding, man. And literally, I'm probably gonna bald at some point. My dad's bald. My granddads are both, like, pretty lacking in hair. It's just something you kind of got to deal with. And I know it's different for a man and a woman, but come on. I don't sit here crying every day that, oh, my hair's falling out. And I know that seems mean, but it's like, don't. The only reason why I kind of go so hard is because it's like, well, you can't go and slap someone. Yeah. Assault, but he's in front of the media. Do kind of beat Assault, but he's in the media, so won't really get done for it. Yeah, it's like if you... It's not okay ever to hit someone. I don't get why people are backing Will Smith. Because, yeah, he's annoyed. But he's in a massive theatre with thousands of people. He's a major, major A-list celebrity. You can't just go up and hit someone. Like, I don't get how that's... I understand why you could be annoyed at the joke. But I can't back going on stage and hitting someone. I don't know. But the other thing is, any of you who are watching, don't just blindly follow what I say. Do your own research. Come to your own opinions. And I'd love for somebody to come back at me and go, hey, this is why you're wrong. In fact, I should post this to TikTok. That's the best way of doing it. Or I'd probably just get a bunch of... But from my research... Hey, look at this, right? Actually. So, not alopecia specifically, but hair loss affects 50% of males and 25% of females by the age of 50. And one of the treatments is just being bald. It's shit, but it's not the end of the world. I don't know. But yeah, he's not being charged for it or anything. Because Chris Rock was just like, nah, bro. Yeah, and to go on stage and be like, I love peace and love. And I need to be able to take criticism. Hey, maybe you could have done with that advice 5 minutes ago. Should we move on now? I don't think we've gone past that sort of thing. No, music. There we go. I think we just skipped over the intro today. This seems a bit happy. Here we go. Don't know. Kind of interesting. Oh, lovely. Okay. Go with something a little lighter. Guys, who here uses a dishwasher? I know, kind of crazy segue, but no, it was a man getting called bald. Ain't no one caring. Exactly. It's just like, yeah, you're just balding, man. I don't know. Because originally I was like, oh, alopecia, scary. And then I realized, hang on a minute, you're literally balding. It's not going to kill her, you know. I have a countertop. Here we go, dishwashers. Countertop dishwasher. Wow, what the hell is that? Countertop dishwasher. Maybe I should do less serious things. I'm better at silly things. Let me show you a countertop dishwasher, guys. Get rid of the Will Smith tubs. Yo, that's fire, you know? That's cheeky. A little dishwasher on the counter. Kind of fire. Hooks up to your kitchen faucet. It's a tap, but all good, all good. Wow. Yeah, it does. No way. That'd be good for like uni. Cool. I didn't know they existed. Okay, so I have a dishwasher, right? And you put inside dishwasher tablets. I'm assuming it isn't a tap. Kitchen faucet? That's what... Oh, wait, are you saying I'm wrong? No. Do you know, faucet confuses me because it's such a, like... America is all for making words easier, like color. We spell colour C-O-L-O-U-R in the UK. America just chopped the U out. And while I could get all high rate about it, it makes sense, you know? It chopping the U out kind of makes sense. It's just easier. It's spelled color. It makes sense, right? So while I could get on my high horse and go, British spelling is better, it's... fuzzy spelling's a load of bollocks anyway. It doesn't make any sense. It kind of... the American way just kind of makes a bit of sense. I don't know. And what's the other thing? They spell a few things just, like, simply. But faucet? Man, tap, three letters. Easy to say. Faucet, it's like faucet. Faucet. Too many... Bro, I don't know what's going on with that word. Come on, America. I thought you were the simple people. Okay. Dishwasher tablets. Stay on topic. They're kind of magic, right? Because... you get them in those little plastic wrappers and you put them in the little tray. You put them in the tray and then they just disappear, right? And I was thinking about this because I was like, firstly, disintegrating plastic can't be good, right? I think that's just any plastic that just disappears into non-existence. Things can't do that. It's got to be some microplastic that's now floating around in a fish's lungs, right? Plastic wrapper's bad for the environment. Exactly, but it's obviously not plastic because it just disappears. And I don't get it. Maybe, we should do some science. I should get a dishwasher tablet, cover it in water, see if it disintegrates. Because I want to see a dishwasher tablet do it in real life. Man, that would be so cool. Because, like I say, I'm confused. Microplastics harm everything? Yeah. It isn't plastic. It's glycerin or something. Google time. What is the wrapper on dish... here we go. Do you have to take the plastic off? See, I thought this. Apparently not. Go on, load. I'm going to be live here. Why are you taking forever? I like Tide Pods. Guys, can we... what's wrong with my internet? Too much Will Smith. The capsules are wrapper-free and designed to release their contents when they come into contact with water. Do not pierce or attempt to unwrap the capsules in hard water conditions. It may be necessary to continue to use finished jet dry rinse aid. Shut up. Depends on the product you've bought. If the tablets come individually loosely wrapped like finished clean, you should remove the plastic wrap before use. You do not need to remove. Huh. Oh, finally. PVA. Oh, isn't that glue? Polyvinyl alcohol, PVA glue, and dishwashing pods. PVA is a water-soluble, self-stable synthetic polymer, creating a dishwasher's pod outer coating. Out of this polymer allows the water user to store and use these convenient pods, knowing that they'll only dissolve when they contact water. Ah. Our dishwasher tablets are unique for they start to come in smart tin rather than a throwaway plastic bag. This will look great in your kitchen and won't need to be stored under the sink. All the packaging is plastic free. Well, that depends on who you buy from. Oh, so it's like PVA, like the glue. It don't disappear. You can use them to clean other stuff if you peel the wrapper off. But you don't get it wet, then it goes all sticky and nasty. Yeah, dissolve into the water. That's sick. The more you know. Bum, 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 bum. Okay. Then the other thing is another kind of question that I have it's still chemicals being released into the environment. It is, yeah. They're probably still not great. But then, you know, what's in fairy liquid, you know? Maybe we should all just eat dirty plates. The other thing I want to look at before I finish off with a... Actually, it's probably not finishing off, but before I tell you a little story. I should probably change my title now. Ah, it's fine. Did I bookmark the tweet? Please tell me I... Oh, I don't think I did. I saw the Tubbo pins, right? Now, firstly... Some funny stuff. I got my Tubbo pins and I opened them and the box was empty. I think that's so funny. I might start this year when I do the Christmas cards. I might just send an envelope. That's so funny. Oh. Yellow. Yeah, I know. I think that is fundamentally the funniest thing you could do is just ship an empty box. You've just paid 60, like, how much were they? How much were the Tubbo pins? Tubbo shop. Shop Tubbo. Fairy liquid, what? Guys, ignore me. Pin set. Oh, so it won't tell me. Cool stuff, to be fair. Lovely stuff. I can't click on it. Oh, anybody know how much they were? I think they were quite expensive, but they are cool. So, you just paid however much money for a fucking empty box. Hilarious, right? But what I did find interesting is these are the actual pins. Here we are. Now, It's the top row is great. You've got like that Tubbo one, 100% Tubbo guarantee. The Tubbo club, something about bees, I assume. The Tubby. Then you've got the buy the sea a Tubbo original. Cool, the bee pin. Anyway, there's some really cool pins. It's then when you start getting to the like emojis and the up and down, upvote, downvote arrows, and the Pepe ones. Can the England flag? That's kind of just like a random addition for Tubbo. I don't know why that's on there. Somebody maybe can explain that one for me. Who owns the copyright to these? Because I can understand some like Etsy shop doing it. But Tubbo is like kind of a proper business. I was slightly surprised that he can just like sell them, like sell the images of the Pepes. I don't know if that was just me that was a bit like, huh? And like the emojis, are they not, do you consider Pepe racist? Is racist what Pepe meant to be? I forgot what the beef was. I don't know the beef. I don't think Pepe's racist. I think Pepe's cool. I think maybe it has been used for racist stuff, but I don't think Pepe itself is inherently racist. Why are you guys still talking about dishwasher soap? But I was just wondering, like, who owns the... Like, surely Tubbo... Has he not had to pay a licensing fee to sell them? You know? And, like, the Reddit surely owned that... I mean, I guess maybe it's a really simple image. You can't really own that. But I don't know. It just kind of was a little bit like, huh? He's allowed to just sell those? I mean, don't get me wrong. They're cool. But I don't know. Bum, bum, ba bum, bum, ba da bum, ba da bum, bum. Those pins are so mid. Shut the fuck up, Oppet. Okay. Now, my final little bit of chat to have with you guys was a bit of beef, actually. And look, I don't like to get involved in drama very often, but sometimes you just have to. Now, my piece of drama is not with somebody I know, not even with somebody, actually, not with anyone. It's with a international company. Now, the international company in question is Amazon limited. I didn't do enough research into this bit. But they've truly let me down, right? Now, I assume you have all heard of a service called Amazon Prime, right? You're probably quite familiar with it. If you have Amazon Prime, did you know that you get a free sub once a month? I actually think I have an Amazon Prime. Hang on a minute. Wait, let me check this. Wait, sub? Hang on. Where's my Prime? I should have a Prime. I have Prime. Wait, sign in. Where is it? My sub to you is a Prime sub. Good. Search Prime Gaming. Wait, where is it? Prime status on Twitch. Here we go. Enjoy your benefits. How do I do it? Why is it not letting me? I want to sub to Samu. Why won't it let me sub to Samu? Oh, fuck's sake. All right, I'll sort it out later. Okay. So, I want to give Samu my money. I have Twitch Prime. Right. Chaz! Wait, here he comes. Thank you so much for the follow, Gangster and Bodge. SpongeBob. What's the gritty? Here he comes. If I have Twitch Prime. Well, I don't. This is the issue. I was trying to use it, and it won't let me. Why won't it come up with a support with Prime? Can I do a slash command to do Twitch Prime or something? You know, how does this work, eh? How does it work, guys? Guys? I've got a Prime Gaming badge, so I obviously have Prime. Just how do I fucking use it? Who knows? T, thank you so much for the Prime. I really appreciate that. On the subscribe, I will show you guys. I will show you. Resubscribe. And it's not here. What about if I try like Johnny? I'm not giving Johnny my Prime. I'll give it to... I guess I'll just do it to see if it works. Again, it's not there. Who knows? Because I've subbed before. It's supposed to be above gift a sub. Where's gift a sub? Oh, there's gift a sub. Who's ringing me? Hi, Chaz.
Hello, Yellow.
Oh, that scared me.
Shall I teach you something?
Yes, please.
You have Prime Gaming,
right? Yes, apparently.
Do you have it through a student free trial or do you pay for it?
I have it through student.
Free trial?
Yeah.
Or do you pay?
Yeah,
you can only do it once.
No, really?
In that 6 months.
No, because I've not done it yet in the 6 months. I only got it the other day.
Click the Prime button at the top. Right, the crown.
The crown, yeah.
Do you have the prime loot?
Yeah.
Oh, it says claim.
I can claim.
Have you had Twitch Prime on this account before?
Yes.
Yeah, that'll be why then. It knows.
No!
Through a free trial, you can only prime once, no matter what credit card you use or anything.
That's so sad.
I'm sorry.
Fuck.
By the way, did you know that they didn't change the price of Prime, but they changed the amount that affiliates get now?
Wait, do I get more money?
No, it used to be $2.50. Now you only get like $2.
Oh, you're joking me.
No, they did it when
they did
the thing like 8 months ago.
I was trying to prime to you, man, but apparently Twitch won't let me.
It's rough.
Right, I need to hear what he says.
Also, I would sub to you, but I'll send you a screenshot if you want. I've got £2.80 in my bank.
Oh, he's trying to prime to me.
I'm sorry, Yellow's nice.
Oh my gosh, he's here.
I would sub. But enjoy the stream. I have homework.
That's all right. I'm hearing so many things, Chaz, right now.
I'm sorry, Yellow's nice.
Wait, I'll see you in a bit then, Chaz, yeah? He's gone. Wait, what's Sammy saying?
Same, I'm gonna mute you. I was just trying to steal.
Thank you so much for the gifted! Oh, was Sammy, my content was priming to you, so.
So much for the
gifted!
Thank you for the gifted.
Oh, was Sammy, my content was priming to you, so.
Ah,
it's a nice little chain of happiness. Isn't that good?
Well, this is fun. Anyways, Yellow, I'm gonna go back to streaming.
All right, bye, Samu.
Chain of happiness. I like how we steal each other's content.
Yeah, we should do it more often. I buy that.
Dude, when I took the break, he replied to my tweet, and he puts, "Whose content am I gonna steal now?" The thing is, I think I steal his content a lot more than he steals mine, because he's always got quite good old content, dude.
That's true.
I have nothing. I just sit here and talk to you guys for like 2 hours straight, and then end the stream and then fall asleep.
Okay, boys, we're gonna have to stop stealing content now. Okay, thank you so much for the support, T. Really appreciate that for the subs and stuff. Great. Okay, where were we? What were we talking about? Dishwasher tablets and then something else. Turbo merch, turbo pins. Oh, I have beef with a major online retailer in the form of Amazon, right? Now, I have Amazon Prime. Now, admittedly, I am on a free 6-month student trial or something. I might say, thanks, Chaz. But I needed a screen protector, right? Because my phone, I had the old one I peeled off on stream the other day, and it was broken. It was really shit. So I got a new screen protector, right? Sorry, I'm getting distracted. Put that away. Just my phone charger. Go away. I don't need to look at the end of it. I don't know what I'm doing. I have beef with a major online retailer, right? I ordered a screen protector. It was like £3 or something, you know. Nice. Look, it's great for me. Probably not so great for the little kid in Taiwan that had to make that, you know. But I got my screen protector, right? However, we had some drama along the way. I ordered my screen protector on Friday. It was Friday during the day. I took my old one off. I was like, I need a new one. Let's get on it. Let's get next day Prime delivery. Okay? Now, I was all excited. I learned a few things on Saturday. I wake up in the morning. There's a little yellow ring on my Alexa. I didn't know I got one. It did that. And it goes, hey, by the way, if you have a yellow ring, it means you've got a notification. So I was like, great. And I ask my Alexa, I go, hey, Alexa, what's my notification? And it goes, oh, by the way, your delivery should be arriving today at approximately 3 p.m. And I went, brilliant. That means I've only got to worry about my phone for like another 12 hours. Then we'll get a screen protector on and it all be good. Now, the day runs on. I went to work. I got back from work. I then realized the little yellow light's on again. And I'm like, huh? And I go, Alexa, what's my alert? And Alexa goes, hey. Did you know that your delivery of a glass screen protector, Todd, I'm going to ban you. You know what? Todd, you're getting banned. /ban Todd Cart 1. sorted. And he goes, hey, by the way, you're, I might ban the phrase cool story, bro. That seems like a, what do you want? Why do you want to be unbanned? I'm doing my bit on stream and you're distracting me. No, I have a good bit planned. You've not heard the end of it yet.
Yeah, yeah, cool story, bro. Can I just tell my... Can I get back and just tell my story?
Yeah, okay, yeah, you ready? You can tell it now. Tell it, say it to the mic.
No, you're going to mute me. I'm not off the door.
No, I'm not going to mute you.
Yeah, look, I've done this stream and stuff a lot longer than you. I know the game.
I'm not going to mute you. I promise I will not mute you.
If you mute me, you have to just end your story about this.
Yeah, okay, no problem.
So...
He didn't know it was going to end cool. fucking hell. Why does it come back so loud every time? Tonkart missed FaceTime kill. Oh, no. I didn't mute him. So, the story continues. It goes, hey, by the way, your delivery will be along shortly. It's just running a little late. And I went, okay, but isn't Amazon Prime meant to be next day? And so I waited at the evening. Alas, I sat by the post box there waiting with my fingers ready to grab it out of the hands of the postman. And alas, it did not come. I wake up Sunday morning. Still no sign of the package. I check the Amazon app. It's not even giving me the little yellow ring anymore to update me on where my parcel is. It just says, hey, by the way, we're running a little late. It doesn't give me an ETA. So, alas, I get home today. And in the mail is my glass screen protector. So, I put it on and it worked perfectly well. Brilliant screen protector. No complaints. However, what I can complain is about the delivery service. Now, because Amazon Prime, I asked, was it from Amazon or another party? It was on Amazon Prime. Amazon, wait, returns and orders. Delivered today. Brand? Prime one-day delivery. It clearly says 4.7 inches. I relate. Country of origin, China. There we go. I need to be more correct. Because Amazon's more like eBay these days. Well, it does say... It doesn't say anything, actually. Anyway, it said it was on Amazon Prime, so I expected it to come on Amazon Prime, and I was let down. Now, look, I did not receive any form of compensation at all. Now, I'm not one to complain. I got the screen protector. It was very good. It was not from Amazon. It was through Amazon. There's the distinction. Yeah, but it says it has the little, like, delivered next day by Prime. So I assume it is from Amazon. Unless they're like, I don't know what they're doing. Todd's now messaging me on Discord. I'll meet him on there in a minute as well. I just started to think to myself, hey, what if, and this is a big what if, I was in a critical condition where, say, my heart was not functioning so well. And the only thing that would keep me alive was a small piece of glass that could be inserted into my vena cava. God, I did biology and I did well. Into my vena cava to separate the organs in order to maintain my existence, right? And Amazon go... Look, I know we said next day, but looking at the facts here, it's not going to be easy. You know, bedtime set for 10 o'clock. Oh, God, I have college tomorrow. looking at the facts here, right? If I was to theoretically be a man with a heart condition, and the only way I would survive was if I had a small piece of glass inserted into my heart within 24 hours, and I look to my mother and I go, "Mum, look, I'm too decrippled, you can't leave my side, you can't go into town and buy it, the only option is Amazon Prime," I would die. And I don't think Jeff Bezos wants that on his conscience. So, here's my proposal, right? I know it's radical. I know it's kind of crazy. But if Jeff Bezos says, "Hey, if you have a parcel and it's on Amazon Prime, we will deliver it next day. Look, Jeff, I expect it next day. There's not much I ask from a man, apart from he delivers a good service." Now, I understand that Amazon employees are underpaid and overworked. But my phone wasn't going to... No. My phone wasn't going to smash itself? That doesn't make sense. Look, I'm fuming. There's no other way of putting it. What's setting off now? Todd, stop messaging me on every social media I have. And if this says cool story, bro, I will hunt you down. Yo, can you put your camera on for me quickly?
I'm quite ill, actually, so...
Can you just put your camera on for me quickly?
What, just so you can say, yeah, cool story, bro?
No, I just want your camera on quickly.
Why do you want my camera on?
Just do it.
No, like, my room's not in a good state.
That's all right, just put your camera on.
I can't, I've got company.
No, you haven't. Stop lying.
I do, though.
What, your dog?
No.
Just put your camera on for me.
I will not be saying in this call or on stream.
Put your camera on.
One sec. Okay, they're leaving the room.
Okay.
Yeah, cool story, bro.
Hang on.
It's my new insult, you know.
Clearly you think you're better than this, that I am. So if you want to take over the stream, it's yours.
Oh, do I get to tell a story? Oh, this is actually sick. Oh, fuck, I don't have a good story. Oh, am I on stream now? Oh, wow. Is that good-looking fella? Can I do it while, like... Oh, hang on. No, I won't, actually.
It's your stream. Hey. Do it how you want.
It's your stream. We've all got the same 24 hours in a day, you know? Hang on, let me get a little song on. One sec. Hang on. Sorry about that, yellow. Sorry about that one. No, I'm just trying to find a song.
Come on, man. The audience are waiting. I can't hear it.
Do you care about DMCA?
Yes.
Okay.
For YouTube VODs.
Yeah, that's fine.
Oh, fuck's sake, man.
Stop crying, bro. Just get back on the track.
Jordan falls and Jordan won.
You know that song. Okay, yeah, anyway, hang on, I'm trying to find your stream. Where the fuck's your stream? Oh, it's here. Can I get unbanned as well? So, my story is actually a lot better.
What do you want? You're literally doing...
So...
Wait, you have to... I've just been raided by Samu. Can you do my thingy?
I'm on this... I can't see the fucking thing, mate, because I'm banned.
Guys, oh, Todd Cart thought he was a better streamer than me, so he's just doing my stream. Yeah, go on.
Samu, oh my god, guys, everyone Twitch Prime. That's how we do it normally. Hey guys, big fan Samu. We love the content. Should have let me join that call. Awesome Ollie, hashtag better. So, the other day, it's actually today, I went to the supermarket. You know what I found? These biscuits. Now, they look like kids' biscuits, yellow. Hands down, the best biscuits in Spain. Now, I'm a biscuit connoisseur over here. You saw what I look like in year 8. Now, I have had 9 biscuits already today. That's not including the Oreos I had for lunch. Do I make it 12?
You know what? Thanks for coming, man. I think I, as weak as it was, I did think, admittedly,
oh,
I'll give
on.
You...
Also, I have also got a problem with Amazon. Because you know what I ordered the other day?
Ah, now we're... Now, hey, this stream's mine now. This stream's mine. I'm not having this again. Cool story.
No.
Yes, Bob. Yes. You've just been hit with a cool story, bro. Exactly.
No. The thing is, like, they put cool story because they actually like my story. It would have been
I don't think they did. Sammy, thank you so much for the raid. I really appreciate that. How was your stream? I saw you watching Mark Rober because I tabbed out a minute ago. Todd is a worse streamer than me. I think we've just seen that. Yes, somewhere I will admit my Amazon story was
weird.
My Amazon story was still a little bit weak. But cool story, Todd. Exactly. Guys, hit him with that shit.
Can people see me? Can people still see me?
No.
Oh, that's good. Can I turn my camera off?
Yeah. No, I didn't. It was shit. Not gonna lie. Yes, Bob! Yes! All right. Mate, thanks. You can go and speak to all your women now.
Yellow.
Yeah.
What are you doing after your stream?
Putting my head in an oven.
Are you really?
Yeah. Can't wait.
Can I FaceTime you while you do that?
Yes.
No, can I actually tell my story about Amazon? It's actually really pissed me off.
Why? What happened to you, Todd?
Well, I ordered some substances and Amazon, yeah? I went on Amazon thinking they'd be delivered. It's Prime as well. It says, your order is not ready yet. We will notify you when it's
out. I told you! It's annoying, isn't it? And what if you needed that in an emergency? What would you do?
I do need it. I need it before August.
What? You've got some time then. When did you order it?
About 2 weeks ago.
They're having you on there. Bloody hell.
£40 it was as well. No, £40.
£40? What substance did you want?
No, I can't tell you that.
All right, go enjoy all your women.
Hang on, before I go yellow.
Yeah?
Can I just tell you something? It's really important.
Yeah, go on.
Jordan 4s or Jordan 1s. Rolex's got more than one. My AP costs 31. Millimeters 41. Stick. Him up with
right,
a stick.
See you later.
Stick.
Good song, that, to be fair. Good song. I don't know all the words very well. I don't know any of the words well. I know some words, not well. Whew. Man, I really wish I still had some more hot cross bun fudge. That would make my day. Well, I do. I just don't have it to hand. You know how it is, guys? You know? Yeah. You get me? Yeah. Cool. Thanks. Now, the other thing I thought I'd mention was this time next week, baby, I will be in another country. That's right. I'm going Portugal, baby. And I am got my fingers crossed that we're going to hopefully get a few streams out there. Now, I do need to check the roaming charges and things like that. But this time next week, maybe not this time next week, but some point next week, we could have a Portugal stream. So, be gassed for that. Because, I mean, obviously you guys can't come on holiday with me. So pretend that you... Did Todd just message me cool story bro again? He did. Stop. You are putting me off. So, be gassed for that. I'm excited for that. So, I don't know. Could be a cool stream. I wish I was seeing Styles because he lives in Portugal. But I'm not. I cry every time. But I'm not going to the Styles as it ends. So I'm not there for very long. So, boys, we're going to expect some brand new busing. What's it called? Content. And also, there should be a really, really sick. I went to this really, really nice stately home today. Because, this is actually something really important that I should include you guys in. So, and you actually might care about. You know how we did that stream about what I should do for Mother's Day? Yeah, well, I finally solved it. I didn't know what to do, so I went to my mum and I said, hey, mum, why don't we go to it? Because my mum loves the National Trust. She's one of them. So I go, hey, mum, why don't we go to a National Trust property? I'll get you a nice scone and a drink. You can have a latte and your little fruit scone. We'll go have a nice day out. It'll be hunky-dory, right? So that's what we did. Bro, I went to these lovely glass houses. We went to this big house. We did a bit of walking. We went in these It's so cool. It's like this little, it's really small. It's a really small glass house. Like, most people just walk past it and go, ah, cool. Bro, I was like, because it's this really cool, they haven't really renovated it, so it's all kind of falling apart a bit. And it's got these big, luscious, green plants in. I don't know what plants they are. I'm not very good at plants. And this really, like, nice stone, like, wall. And I've got this really, really sick, couple of sick Instagram posts that I'm going to post, hopefully, tonight if my mother's not gone to bed so I can get grab her phone and go, Mum, can I transfer the photos, please? So, I actually cannot wait to post that because, so look at my Instagram, guys. Thanks. Mate, unban me. I'm watching this. Bro, I thought you had company. / unban Todd Car 1. Does he lose his VIP for that? I hope so. We are watching this. Hey, Todd's significant other. What's up? Hi. I'm yellow is nice, but you can call me Ned, of course. Maybe hit me up in the DMs. I don't know. Like, Todd's not a great guy, so... anyway... I'll see you later. She's at... Hey, at least she wasn't 14. That's all I can say. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. Guys, I think it's start time we start having a look around Twitch. At least she doesn't have a funny accent and has red hair. What? Don't explain that one, please. I don't want to know. Guys, I think it is time. Yes, it is time. Guys. Oh, I need my Spotify open. something went wrong. Oh, shit. Hang on, guys. Six. 3, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bah. Oh, we've got another advert. Two adverts. What we're watching? What are we? We're not watching anything. We are. Guys, thank you so much for watching the stream. I hope you've enjoyed. Please stick around for the raid, because the more of you the raid, the cooler I look. We are going to raid Fig, because he's a cool bloke. I met him this one time. He was kind of cool. I'll see you all later. Thank you so much for watching. Go have a good evening. Bye. Go enjoy your lives or something. I don't know. What do you want to do with yourselves? See you all in a bit. But wait, hang on, let me get to the good bit. Wait, get to the good bit. You ready? 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 1, 2, 3, 4.